Now we will do another problem. That is second one we can take. There are similar problems in the textbook, in the exercise, and as the example problems, you can practice that problems. Now we have another problem, 11/12. Let us do this without performing actual divisions. So how to do this? What we have to do? Without performing actual division, p by q, this divisor you have to factorize. 12 you have to factorize. 2 6 are 12, 2 3 are 6, 3 1 are 3. 12 we can write as 2 into 2 into 3, that is 2 square into 3. It is nothing but a q, na? Q. So q here we are getting in the form of 2 power n into 3. As I told you, we don't need any other prime number over here. We need only 2 and 5, or at least 2 or 5. Between 2 and 5 at least 1 should be there, but other prime factor should not be there. Since we are getting 3 here, this 11/12 we can write as 11/2 square into 3. Without performing actual division, we can say it is a non-terminating, repeating or recurring decimal, because 3 is a factor here. Over here we are getting. So q, that is 12, so we are getting 11/12 equals to 11/2 square into 3, that is q divisor. Q we are getting in the form of 2 square into 3, that means it is not in the form, it is not in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. 3 is the extra factor we are getting here. If extra factor we are getting instead of 2 and 5, we can say that it is a non-terminating repeating. Okay, for terminating decimal, it should be in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. For non-terminating recurring, it should not be in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. You can see here, 2 is there, but other than 2, 3 is there. So we can say it is not a terminating decimal. At 2 and 5 only should be there. So it is not in the form. 2 is there, but 5 is not there. 3 is there. We don't need 3 here. Therefore, 11/12 is non-terminating, okay, repeating decimal. Right. Hope you have understood this. I think everyone is having the doubt, why 2 is there now, why again you are saying it is a non-terminating repeating. 3 is there, you have to think about it. 3 is there, we don't need 3, we need at least 2 or 5 only. Other than 2 and 5, we don't need any other factor over here. In the previous question, we got only 5, na? 5 power 5. So, at least 5 should be there, or at least 2 should be there. Other than 5 and 2, other factors should not be there. Okay, 2 along with 2, 3 is there, that's why we are saying it is a non-terminating repeating decimal. Okay, I think, hope you have understood the rational numbers, finding the rational numbers without performing actual divisions. Similar, there are so many similar problems. You can go through textbook, exercise problems are there, and some examples also there, you can go through it. Okay, so there are so many exercises problems, you can go through it, but one more problem I want to teach you, that is the next one is 23/2 cube into 5 square, this one, and the fourth one is 129/2 cube into 5 square into 7 power 9. This the questions I am taking by myself. You can make your own questions also and practice. So look over here. Can you say whether it is terminating and non-terminating? See the divisor q. Q is in the form 2 cube into 5 square. Q is coming in the form of 2 cube into 5 square. That is, it is in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. Both 2 and 5 are coming here. In the previous problem, in the first problem we got only 5, but then also we can say it is a terminating decimal. I told you, now 2 and 5 both should be there, or at least one should be there. Other than 2 and 5, the other factor should not be there. Only 2 and 5 should be available in the factors of Q, 2 and 5. So it is a terminating decimal. So this number 23 by 2 cube into 5 square is terminating decimal. Here you have 2, 5 and 7 also we have. We don't need any other factor over here. 2 and 5 both are available here, but 7 is not, 7 extra is there. So what we can say about it? We can say that it is a non-terminating recurring decimal, because only 2 and 5 should be there. So it is not in the form Q is equal to 2 cube into 5 square into 7 power 9 is not in the form. Is not in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. Hope you have understood. So what is it? It is a non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, hope you have understood the differences between terminating and non-terminating decimals without performing actual division. Okay, now we have the problem writing the terminating decimal in the form of p by q. In the previous section, we have previous questions we have done that writing p by q in the form of decimal form. Now what we will do? Write the decimal forms in the form of p by q. Okay, now we have the question. Write the following decimal form. Decimal form you have to write in p by q form. Decimal numbers will be given to you. Writing the decimal numbers in the form of p by q. Okay, where q is not equal to 0, p and q are co-primes. Co-primes means the numbers which has only one as a common factor. Okay. And after solving this, you have to write the denominators in the form of, okay, also write the denominators in 2 power n into 5 power m form. Right, now we have the first question. 15.265. This is a decimal form. Write this decimal form in the form of p by q. How to do this? Here, where is the point? Point is here after 15. After point, how many decimal digits we have? 1, 2, 3. So, what we have to do? This point, we have to shift to the right side after the 3 digits, that is after the last digit. We are shifting this here. So, 15,265. This is 15.265. We are shifting point. So, the point is from here, we are shifting to the right side after the last digit. So, what will be the changes? How many digits it is jumping? 3 digits. So, here as we all know, 1 is the denominator in all the numbers. So, what we can do, because 3 digits it is jumping to the right side, you have to add 3 zeros in the denominator. Now, that is 15. If you want, we can cancel also. 5 and 0 are the last digits. We can divide them by, or we can cancel them also. But you have to write in this form, na, 2 power n into 5 power m. So, what we can do? 1000 we will factorize. That we can factorize as 10. 10 ones are 10, 10 zeros are 0, 10 zeros are 0. 10 tens are 100, 10 ones are 10. After factorization, we are getting 15,265 by 10 to the power 3. 10 to the power 3, we can write as 2 into 5. Can we write? 2 5s are 10. But this power 3, we have to apply here, 2 and 3. So, this is the decimal, this is the p by q form of 15.265. In the question, it is also given, write the denominators in 2 power n into 5 power m form. So we are writing, we have factorized and we got 10 to the power 3 2 power cube into 5 power 3. So this decimal number is written in the form of p by q as this 15,265 by 2 cube into 5 cube. So we can say this is a terminating decimal. Look, already it is a terminating decimal because it terminates at 5. So answer what we are getting, it is a terminating decimal, but it is in the p by q form, you have to convert it. Now we have the next one. Next 0.4, simple one I want to take. 0.4 you have to write in the p by q form. Simply we are shifting the digit to the right side. 4 by what we will get, 1 is already present there, it is jumping to the after one digit only. So you have to add only 10. If you want, we can also cancel. 2 to the 4 and 2 5 is 10. 2 by 5. It is in the form of 2 by 5. Okay, 2 power n into 5 power m. Or else this we can also write as 4 by 10 means 4 by 2 into 5. If it is coming in the 2 power n into 5 power m, 4 by 2 into 5. 2 power 1, 5 power 1. Or if you want to cancel, we are getting 2 by 5 as the answer. Right. The next one we have 23.34. 23.34 we have to do. So, what we will get? Point is here, we are shifting, point is coming to the right side after the last digit. So, how many zeros you have to add here? 2 zeros. 2334 by 100 means 10 square. 10 square we can simply write as 2 into 5. 10 we can write as 2 into 5. 2 square into 5 square. So, these are the three problems. Similar problems are there in the textbook, in the exercise and examples. Do these problems and try these questions also there. All that you can practice and you can create own questions. These questions also you can create. You can take your own numbers, now old decimal numbers. You have to make your own decimal numbers and you have to practice this kind of problems. In the previous section, we have done problems of rational numbers. We have converted the decimal form in the p by q form and p by q form in the decimal form. Rational number has two types, terminating decimal and non-terminating repeating decimal. Now, we will do problems based on irrational. As we all know, irrational numbers are numbers can't return in the p by q form. The numbers which we can't write in the p by q form. Irrational numbers. The numbers which we can't write in p by q form. Examples are root 2, root 3, root 5 and so on. Right, the numbers which we can't write in the p by q form, and it has one type, that is non-terminating and non-recurring. In rational numbers we have terminating decimal, non-terminating, recurring, but here non-terminating and non-recurring. Here recurring, no, here it is non-recurring. Example 1.368 like this. So same number is not repeating here. It is non-terminating, it will not terminate, but other than that, the numbers, all the decimals are non-terminating, okay, and non-recurring. The numbers are not repeating here, different numbers we will get, 3, 6, 8, 5, any. This is just an example. Now, based on this, you have to prove, we have one problem, proving these kind of numbers are irrational. We have the problem, show that root 2 is irrational. I am saying you it is a irrational, but you have to show also here that it is a irrational. If you find the value of root 2 by division method or by calculator also, if you find, you will get 1.414 like this. So it is a root 2 is, this is the value of root 2, non-terminating and non-recurring. So root 2 is obviously it is a irrational number. But here you have to prove it how it is a irrational number. By division method also we can prove. Okay, by division, one more method is the division method, and by if you check in the calculator also you will get this root 2 1.414 answer. You will get continuous, it will not stop. So it is a non-terminating and non-recurring. Now you have to prove, show that root 2 is irrational. I am doing for root 2. Similar problems you can do, like show that root 3 is irrational. Same method you have to apply for the remaining problems also. I am doing for root 2 only. So to prove root 2 is irrational, what we have to do? First, we are assuming here, first step is, let us assume, and this is an important question, it can come in the 4 marks in the exams. Let us assume that, we are assuming that root 2 is rational. We are assuming it is not a rational, but we are assuming it is a rational. First step, suppose if it is a rational, it should be in the form of p by q. It is not a rational, it is an irrational, so it should not be in the form of p by q. But here we are assuming that it is a rational. Instead of irrational, we are assuming it is a rational. If it is a rational, means root 2 we can write as p by q form. Okay, root 2 we can write as p by q form, because we are assuming it is a rational. Now p and q are coprimes, that means here p and q are coprimes. Coprimes means they should not have common factors other than one. That means p and q have no common factors other than one. That means they should not have common factor other than one, then only they are rational. Here we are assuming it is a rational, root 2 is equals to p by q. After that, what is the next step? Because root 2 is there, applying square on both sides, squaring on both the sides. Root 2 whole square is equal to p square by q square. Here square and root get cancelled. Root 2 whole square equals to p square by q square. Here root and 2 get cancelled. 2 is equals to p square by q square. What we will do? We will shift this q here. 2 into q square is equal to p square. That means dividing both this by, that is multiplying both this by q square. Q square into q square. Why we are doing? To shift to q square, we are multiplying both the sides by q square. Here we are multiplying q square. Here also we are multiplying q square. That means this q square get cancelled. 2q square is equals to p square. Here we are getting. Okay, we got 2q square is equal to p square. Now look here, p square is equal to 2q square. That is p is not, p has a factor 2. That means p square is 2 into q square. That means we can say p square is even number. It is divisible by 2. Okay, p has a factor 2. P square is even. By looking over here, we can say that p square is even number, because we can see this, the factors of 2, p, the factors of p is 2 into q square. 2 is a factor. Since 2 is a factor of p, we can say that 2 is a even number. P square is even because it has a factor 2. Now p square is even means, suppose if even into even, even number, if you multiply it with even, we will get even. That means suppose if I take one even number 2, if I take one even number 4, 2 4s are 8, we are getting even answer. Even number multiplied with even number, we will get even. What about odd? Odd into odd, if you multiply, you will get odd number. Odd, if I take 3 into 7, 3 7s are 21. Odd multiplied with odd, answer is odd. Even multiplied with even, we will get even. That means if p square is even, p into p, if p into p is even, can we write p square as p into p? Yes, p square is nothing but p into p, no. P into p is even. As I told you, even into even is even. That means these both are even only. P square is even means p is also even. Right. This p is nothing but it is p square even means p is also even. So what we will do, we will take here p is equal to, these are the steps to prove that root 2 is irrational. First we have assumed that root 2 is rational. Next we have applied square on both sides and we have taken it as root 2 as p by q because it is rational. Irrational means we can't take it as p by q. Because we have assumed it is rational, we have taken it as root 2 as p by q. Applying square on both sides, we got these things. So these are the steps. Q square multiplied over here. Okay. So 2q square is equal to p square. Now while looking at this, we can say p square is an even number because these are the two factors of p. Right. P square we can write as 2 into q square. Because of 2, we can say it is an even. And it has a factor 2. If it has factor 2, p square is even. P into p is also even. If p square is even, p is also even because even into even is even. 2 into 4, 8. This is an example. So p is also even. Now this is the next step. Because it is even, we can write p as some 2 into k. Why we are doing this? Just to prove that root 2 is irrational. Now what we are doing? Taking p as 2 into k is nothing but some integer. Actually, what we are doing here, to prove that it is irrational, as we have assumed it is rational, we don't want common factors of p and q. P and q are co-primes. They should have only one factor, one as a common factor. Here, we got p factor of p as 2, right? So, let's see what will be the next. P is equal to 2. P is equals to 2. 2q square is equal to p square. What we have done previously, here p is equal to 2q, you have to substitute. 2q square is equal to, in the place of p, we are taking it as 2. Why we are taking this? Because p is an even number. So instead of writing p, we are taking it as, we are taking it 2 into any integer k. Why we are taking 2? Because it is even number. Now 2q square is equal to, 2k square means 2k into 2k. Here this side 2 and this side 2 get cancelled. Q square is equal to 2 k into k, k square. Now see, in the previously we got p, here we can see that p has a common factor 2, p is an even number. Here also after taking this value p is equal to 2q, we got something, after solving this we got q square is equal to 2k square. That means q is also even. Okay, we got q is also even because q square is nothing but 2 into k square. 2 is there, 2 is a factor. 2 is a factor of q. How? Because after p is a even number, we have substituted over here p is equal to 2. After getting this, q square is equal to 2 square. Q square is also even. That means 2 is a factor of q square. 2 is also a factor of q. Q square means q. That means first we have taken a q square. Because here we got q square. No. Q square is equal to 2k square. That we can also write as 2 is a factor of q square means obviously it is 2 is also a factor of q. That means q square is even. 2 is a factor means q square is even. If q square is even, q is also even. As I told you, even into even is even. So q square means q into q is also even. Q is also even. That means both p and q are even. We got p है, p is even. Now in the previous in the beginning we got p as even, now we got q also even, both are having p and q has common factor 2, that we don't want actually, right? We got 2 as a common factor, q p of p and q, we want only 1 as a common factor. But we got p and q as a common factor of 2 as a common factor of both p and q, that means p and q are not coprimes now. P and Q are not coprimes. So what we have assumed that? We have assumed that root 2 is rational. Root 2 is rational, why? Because if P and Q is not, P and Q should not have common factors other than 1. But we got 2 as a common factor of both P and Q. That means root 2 is not equal to P by Q, because our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is wrong. Our assumption was root 2 is rational. Root 2 can be rational if they don't have common factor as 2. But we got the common factor 2 is the common factor of P and 2 is a common factor of Q. We got 2 as a common factor of both P and Q. We don't want any other common factors. Okay, that means our assumption is wrong. We can say that P and Q are not coprimes now. In the beginning what we said, root 2 equals to P by Q, we have assumed that P and Q are, that means they are coprimes. They can be coprimes if they have only 1 as the common factor. But other than 1, we got 2 as a common factor. Both P and Q both are having common factor 2. That means what we have assumed that P and Q are coprimes, our assumption was wrong. Our assumption is wrong. So our assumption is wrong, we can say that root 2 is irrational. That means root 2 we can't write in the form of P by Q. So in this way we have proved that root 2 is irrational. Similar problems you can do for root 3, root 5, root 7. Okay, this kind of problems you can do using the same process, using the same steps you can use it. Instead of taking 2, you can use 3, 5 and 7, and you can practice this kind of problems. Okay.